Let's look at a brand new feature in Pages 6.1 that allows you to link to other spots inside the same document. So before you could link to web pages very easily. You can even link to an email to create a new email. But now you can link inside the document. So let's look at how to do that. These are called bookmarks. So the first part of what you want to do is define where you want to jump to. So say you've got a document like this and you want to jump to a paragraph like this paragraph here from someplace earlier. You can select the area that you want to bookmark or just one word or even just put the cursor at the beginning of the section you want to bookmark. And then you can go to Insert Bookmark. That's the easiest way to do it. And it puts that bookmark there. So now to link to it, you would go to where you want the link to occur. So let's select a word here. And I can insert a link. So I would go to Insert and then, Format, Add Link. And then you see there's the web page and email from before. Now I can do Bookmark. So that's the text there to display. That's the type of link, bookmark. And then this is where it's going to go to. And you can see it's going to jump to that text there, which is on page 5 right now. So now I hit Go to Bookmark. And that will jump me there to see whether or not that's where I want it to go. And I could have just closed the window and it just would have left it there. Now you can see here that there's this little underline there. If I click on it, it will actually give me the ability to either edit or to jump to the bookmark to test it out. So when you export this in various different formats now, you'll get an actual link. So let's try exporting it as a PDF. I'm going to go to File, Export to PDF. I'm going to just export it to the desktop. There's the file there. I'm going to open it in preview just by double clicking it. And there it is. I'm in preview. And you can see it's underlined, that word there. And if I click it, it jumps right to that paragraph. So you can create various different links very easily that way. And you had some other options as well. Let's go and select another word here. And we'll do Format, Add Link, Bookmark. And you can see here I can choose a bookmark I've created, or I can also choose suggested bookmarks. So where do these suggested bookmarks come from? Well, they come from the different titles and headings I've created. If I go to Manage Suggestions, it comes up with a list of all the different styles, and it'll start off by default with titles and headings being in that list. I can add my own custom style to that list as well, or say use subtitles or take some of these away, and these will appear under suggested bookmarks. If I select one, now this is a bookmark here. I can hit, click on it, go to bookmark, and you can see it jumps to that right there. There's also a way to look at all your bookmarks. If you go to the document sidebar and you click on bookmarks right here, you can see a list of all the suggested ones. And you can see it puts them in order. It will add, you see it added when I did this heading here and I said I wanted to use that as a bookmark, it added that as a bookmark. And I've got the two and I can jump back and forth between them. I can control click on them and rename, delete, etc. So like for instance here I can go to this one here. I can rename it something maybe that means a little more to me. And you can see it doesn't change the text here, but maybe it makes it easier for me to add that as a reference, just internally for me. It's not something the user would ever see. So you can also add a bookmark for something you've selected by using this Add Bookmark button. And you can see it adds it there. So you have a lot of versatility in this to be able to add these links within page documents. It's a feature a lot of people have wanted for a long time, and now we have it.